Hey, check, check. Stefan Harris talks about. Okay, I ain't gonna talk long, y'all. It's top three for me. Unless you put a filter on it. This is a rare thing. This is the second night of a 2-week engagement by our leader. I think I described him as local jazz bass star. Or did I say local bass jazz star? Or did I say jazz star local bass? He's a star. He's a leader. He has a very clear vision and conception of what he's trying to do and the people he tries to surround himself with. And that's Jamale Davis on the cultivated. And he's got recordings to celebrate, which I'm not sure if they're here. Did you bring any with you?
I did.
He's got some recordings. I think if you pay him and ask him nicely, he'll sign them for you. Well, the reason we did this is because, firstly, we haven't had him here in a while, but also because it's an opportunity for us to check out musicians who are bringing a different mindset, the same heart, soul. You got the training down. You got the knowledge of harmony, the knowledge of swing, the understanding of connection. But they're bringing a different mindset to different material because of the cats on the stage. That's part of what makes this music so great. And we get to share with them because we're a part of it too. So last week was a fabulous trio. And they worked their way through a set, two sets of wonderful music. This is his working quintet with some fabulous musicians. One of my favorite cats on the trombone, our local master, Mr. Mosca, and Mferghu on piano. And they're going to take us on a journey that's going to be very different, but connected to what you had last week. And remember, everything we record is live stream. And I hope they can't hear me, Ivanya. They can't.
Thank you. Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. Good. You guys hear me? All right. Good evening. Good evening. That was. How's everybody doing? Good.
Good. Good.
Yeah. I know that voice. Welcome to Clement's Place. You just heard an original, morbidly titled, "The Only Way Down from the Gallows Is the Swing." You get them with the joke first, and then, you know, you keep moving. There you go. Thank you. Obviously, this is comedy hour for us. It's not jazz. It's, you know, it's going to be comedy hour. On drums, we have Ben Zweig on drums. Give it up, Ben Zweig. In all Italian front. Dario Terzulo on tenor saxophone. Give it up. Man, my brother, John Mosca on trombone. Yeah. Yep. They're all my brothers, but you know, John is, you know, it's like a bigger brother. And my willing heart on piano. My other brother, Mferghu. Give it up. Dig, for those that came last Thursday and you heard the wonderful Sasha Perry trio. It was Sasha and Gary Kikiz. Killing, man. The album that we did two albums, Morse Codes, and last Thursday we were celebrating Morse Codes Part 2. But the first album, fun fact, is dedicated to this man right here who has been an inspiration to Sasha. So, you know, you're about to hear some real, real music. Like, you know, just keep your ears glued, you know. We're happy to have him. What can I say that I didn't say last time? You know, a baby of Newark, born in Newark, a child of Irvington, 18th Avenue murder once again. Yep. We're here. I started playing jazz while attending Rutgers back in 2005. I loved the music. I bought a bass, and I worked. Went to the city every weekend and played and got connected to some real, you know, solid influences, and, you know, this is what happens when you do the things that you love. You get a chance to celebrate life and document life with the people that, you know, have meant something to you, with the music that has become not only music, but actually a way of living. The lessons I learned from trying to get through this harmony, trying to get through these changes, is pervasively sound to everything else that happens in life. You know, jazz is, to me, one of the greatest microcosms of what life really is. You know, this music really offers opportunities to get presented with friction, and you got to try to resolve it as beautifully as possible, and you got to do it over and over and over again. If that's not, like, you know, what life is every day, it's like, you know, you try to make it through the changes every day in life, right? Enough talking. I've done enough. I'll talk a little bit on a second set to, you know, give you guys more of an idea of what this particular gig represents. It's three albums that I was able to record in March of 2023. This is the third installment. All of the records that I've put out are usually self-funded. They come straight from my pockets. This is the first album that actually hit a label that, you know, supported what I did, and they're going to release it sometime this spring. The record label is Steeplechase. That particular album title is called Run with the Hunted. So, a happy album, you know. Enough talking, we're gonna play. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. At this time, we're going to feature Dario on a ballad. I can't get started. Let's do that. Mosca's turn. We're going to feature Mosca on a tune that we love to feature Mosca on. And with this tune, it comes a story. I'm going to let him tell the story. And, you know, the first time I heard this tune, he announced it like this. He said, you know, Barry Harris didn't write this tune for me, but he wrote it on me. So I'll let him finish the rest of it. Mosca?
That's true. That's true. Of course, you all know who Barry Harris is, the great, 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 great Barry Harris, and inspiration and teacher to hundreds and hundreds of thousands of people around the world, and they're still doing it on the computer. And so I happened to be at his place, and he said, Mosca, can you do this? And for the first two years that I knew him in class, he used to call me trombones. So I thought it was a real progress when he was calling me Mosca. So he said, can you do this? He just played a little cell, and I said, yeah. And he said, well, how about this? I said, yeah, Barry, you know, believe it or not, on the trombone, that's not so hard. It all kind of fits. And then we got into a big discussion about how the piano, when no matter how fast the piano player is playing, he has to make kind of the same motion. But for a trombone player, our motion, the tonguing motion, gets smaller when we go faster, so it's a little bit easier. It's one of the secrets. Don't tell anybody. This is one. So we kept going and wound up with a song based on All God's Children Got Rhythm. And so Barry called this one Flight of the Humble Bird.
Thank you.
Yeah. I'm sure that if you go to the page, they have an option where you can get like a Rutgers website Sherpa that'll walk you through to get you to the donation spot. Welcome back. Second set. First set was, did something. Something was done. Something else is about to get done, but I'll talk a little bit more right now. Once again, we're celebrating the third installment of the recordings that I did in March of 2023. This record, once again, is called Run With The Hunted. It will come out on Steeplechase sometime this spring. So, you know, it's the first album. It will be my seventh album as a leader, but this is the first one that was actually on a record label that I did not have to, you know, fund out of my pocket. Which, thank you. And I'll just give you a brief rundown of all three of the albums. The first album that I released is another trio album. This one consisted of guitar and drums. The guitar player is an Italian by the name of Simone Faeda. It was his first time in the States, and we've become Instagram friends. He appreciated my music, I appreciated his. So he was coming to the States, and I said, you know, let's celebrate this moment by documenting it with an album. And we literally just recorded it in my apartment, produced by Neil Miner, you know, all family. And we did 10 songs. And usually with all my albums, all seven albums, I record the same. 4 hours, 2 takes, that's it. Take the best one, go. So we did the same thing, 10 songs. I presented 10, he presented 10, we recorded it. As a gift to him and just, you know, friendship, I split it in five. Like, I gave him five tunes, so he's gonna release the other five in Italy at some point. I released it, but I also documented the whole thing video-wise, so I released it as a short film. I call that album Live from the Hydrant House, Volume 1, because it's the first installment of things that's gonna happen at my place. I got my place set up for more music like this. Called the Hydrant House because I just got a lot of paintings of hydrants, so that's what I call it, right? The second album, we celebrated last Thursday with the trio with Sasha, Gary Kakirzu. Oh, and Gary Kakirzu was on the drums for that first album. She was here with us last Thursday to celebrate the second album, Morse Code 2, The New Brutalism. Like I said last week, the title just is basically an architectural reference. If you know architecture, you know New Brutalism. It's basically working with concrete, building these very big foundations, these things that are functional. They stay around forever. They, you know, they patina. You know, they get well patinaed, and they sometimes they look horrible, but the structure is still there. Sometimes it's, you know, it's a beautiful building. It could be whatever. I just appreciate the architecture part of it. And this album is what it is. It's Running with the Hunted is a reference to Charles. It's a Charles Bukowski book. I just like the title. I like what it represents. When I thought about, you know, running with the hunted, to be the hunted or to be the hunter, which one would you rather be? To me, I think you'll have a swinging time being the hunted, because obviously there's something that that person wants, something that you have that you're being hunted for. We can go deeper, whatever, but that's basically the gist of it. I got a chance to record with my brothers. It was fun. That's what it is. But also, another treat. I'm closing out this weekend with another showing of the short film tomorrow. I have some friends here that made this possible, and I'm going to invite them so they can tell you just a little bit, and you know, we can move on to the playing after that. So Queen, if you don't mind coming up and just saying a little piece about it. Everybody, this is Queen Moore, the head curator for Femme Curator. Special talent, poet, dear friend.
Thank you, Jamale. Good evening, everybody. Good evening. Isn't he excellent? Aren't they excellent? So we have the pleasure, my team at Femme Curator Arts, to do another film screening of Live from the Hydrant House at Indigo Residence, the old Indigo Hotel. So my company serves as an activation and pop-up curatorial team where we just provide experiences in this whole ensemble. Or am I using the right language? I'm a teacher, but I need the right. Okay, am I doing good? Okay. An ensemble. as this group, we get to see this in the theater. So there's a 12-seat theater at Indigo Residence, and we've been invited to show this film among some other films. And this Saturday, there's a two-time slot. You have a 2 p.m. and a 3 p.m., so come join us. Get excited. There's a lot happening in Newark.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Now we're going to play. Stick around.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Listening to Ben Zweig on drums. Give it up, Ben Zweig. Dario Terzulo on tenor saxophone. Dario Terzulo. John Mosca on trombone. Give it up. And the great Mferghu on piano. Give it up. Yeah, yeah, yeah. My name is Jamale Davis once again. We'll try to squeeze out two more, right? Two more. So I hope you enjoyed it because we're having fun up here. You know, I came out my jacket, you know, a little sweat never hurt anybody. This has been, like I said last time, my heart continues to be full. You know, I haven't played in a while, so it's just like it. You know, I'm shaking the rust off, but I remember what I love about this, and, you know, it will continue to be a part of my life, even if I don't play, but now I'm playing, so let's, you know, continue on with this, right? Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. And mind you, I'm fucking